Firefighters of Reddit. What's the dumbest way you've seen someone accidentally start a house fire? The old turkey fryer on the wood deck is always a favorite. In the city of Colorado Springs, the local news did a fluff piece about candle safety near Christmas. After they were done filming, the store owner that they were filming in took the crew out to breakfast. She didn't put out the candles and burned several shops to the ground. The film crew was there to film her breakdown when they realized what caused the fire. Wow, that's a textbook example of irony. I worked for a restoration company. A family cut a small tree down and tried to stuff it up their fireplace to burn. The flute was so crammed with leaves that smoke started to fill the living room. They tried to pull the tree out and that's when it really caught fire. They tried to pull it out of the house, they got as far as the front door. All of them had second/third degree burns on their hands/arms and the fire destroyed the front room and entryway of their house. The insurance company asked us if we thought it was a case of fraud, and we told them no, these people are just really stupid. That is the stupidest thing I've read all day, and I spent an hour in an AskReddit thread about the stupidest demands it workers have gotten earlier. A Roomba knocked a scented candle over and set fire to the rest of the room. The guy said he knew the Roomba did it because he watched the whole thing happen, but didn't do anything because he thought it was funny. I can just imagine the Roombas turning to face the guy and saying something like they'll never believe you. Teenager was charcoal grilling in the attached garage during the winter. When done, he decided the best place to dispose of the hot coals was into a cardboard box in front corner of the garage closest to the house. Yeah, it went about as well as you can imagine. He forgot to turn the coals off. My dad was a firefighter, and he once went to a house fire that was started by the old lady who lived there. She liked to burn candles, but didn't like the wax build up that would form in the cavity, so she would soak up the liquid wax with a napkin. She was doing this when she accidentally brushed a wax-soaked napkin up against the flame. She panicked and threw the napkin into the trash, where all the other wax napkins were. As the trash can exploded into flames, she fled the house, but not before she went to her oxygen tanks and flooded the house with pure oxygen because she thought that it would smother the fire. The exact worst thing to possibly do. I'm guessing they were not able to save the house after that move. I think the only part of the house that was significantly damaged was the basement. All the oxygen tanks were in the basement with the fire, but she shut the basement door on her way out, so she simultaneously helped and choked out the fire. I'm sure there was some smoke damage, but I don't think the house was completely burned down. A fairly common one, but the response was interesting. Early February, Western PA. Guy's pipes freeze on the coldest day of the year, -8°F. He tries to thaw them with a propane torch. Sets the wall on fire. Tries to put the fire out. Fails. Finally calls 911. Fire chief is 1/2 block away. Is on scene in under a minute. Basement is fully involved. Main floor catching. First engine arrives in under 5 minutes. Doors are blocked by fire. Exterior attack only. I'm on an attack line, spraying water into the second floor window. After 40 minutes, another firefighter comes to relieve me, but since I'd been getting back spray, I'm frozen to the ground. He has to pull me loose. 2 hours later, we have it knocked down. The insurance adjuster shows up. Assistant chief explains what started the fire. Adjuster replies, "Oh, yeah, we know. It's okay, we insure for stupid. Nobody got hurt. Family gets a much nicer house out of the deal." Holy shit, you were frozen to the ground from the spray? That's both amazing and hilarious. Firefighting in freezing temps is miserable. Why not just warm up from the fire/s? In college, a girl in the dorms was making popcorn which, not sure how but somehow, caught fire in the microwave. She didn't want to get into trouble for it, so she grabbed the flaming bag of popcorn and threw it into the nearby trash can. Then proceeded to cover the fire with paper towels to smother it. She actually thought it would work. It did not work. I came back exhausted after work to find the dorm building surrounded by fire trucks. College students are really something else. My school is a nursing and engineering school, full of the people that will be staffing hospitals and designing the technology of tomorrow. I cannot tell you how many times I was awoken in the middle of the night because one of these beacons of the future got stoned and put a burrito in the microwave with the foil still on it. I'm a firefighter, but this wasn't in my district. A guy was attempting to forge a sword, timesunion.com link, in a burn barrel in an alley, based on something he watched on the History Channel. The embers from the forge lit up the building he lived in and destroyed 3 multi-family residential buildings. Forgetting to close the bottom of your grill, then going overboard with the lighter fluid. A friend of mine in the 5th grade caught himself on fire with lighter fluid when the charcoal wasn't really starting. They used to sell extension arms you could hook to the lighter fluid can, and he used one of those, but the fire ran up the dripping fluid into the can. No problem, he just walked over and set it down and released the holder, at which point the can tipped over. It was only about 1/4 full, so little spilled out, but he went to tip it back up when it exploded right when his head was above it and the burning lighter fluid covered his head. He was pretty smart for an 11-year-old. He remembered where the fire extinguisher was, ran over, pulled the pin, and sprayed himself, but he still had bad burns all over his face and head. Not a house fire, but really good. Late 1980s. Guy was driving an old beat-up Lincoln. He turned a corner to go up a steep hill, but the road department had recently ground the asphalt down in preparation to repave. A storm sewer manhole cover was sticking up about 4 inches. As he went over it and up the hill, the rear of his car dragged due to the pavement height difference, and the manhole ripped open his fuel tank and sparked off the gas. Guy described it: I heard a scraping sound, looked in the mirror, and there was this trail of fire chasing me up the hill, like I was the road runner. He pulled into a gravel parking lot and tried to kick a brake in the trail before the fire got there, but it jumped the gap and led the car. By the time we got there, it was a total loss. He actually thought it was kind of funny. The only real loss was his wife's purse, with her license and credit cards. The car was insured, and they got a pretty nice payout for it. Yeah, that is a good one. I can imagine watching that all go down, lol. I'm glad everything was okay in the end. The driver thought it was hilarious. He's driving along, looks in the mirror, and there's a fire chasing him, and nowhere else. He was really upbeat about the whole thing. Based on the stories from relatives, the answer is by allowing 10 years worth of dry lint to accumulate inside the machine until it just bursts into flames. It was not an isolated case. This happened this past fall, but a family had a fairy house that was outside, right next to their woodside's house. The fairy house was made out of an old tree and had a bunch of decorations in it, including incense candles. One evening, they decided that they would light the candles for the fairies, which then caught the tree on fire, which then extended into the house. Since it started on the outside, it ran up the side of the house and got into the attic and second floor. The family was home, but in the first floor. While this was happening, it wasn't until someone driving on the road saw the smoke and went to alert the family. Luckily, we were able to save the structure. There was a bit of damage to the roof, attic and second floor, but the home owners are rebuilding those areas. Fairies were displeased, I guess. Not a firefighter, but the apartment building I lived in at the time caught fire because all my neighbors smoke and throw their cigarette butts into the ground, which happened to be fresh mulch, before going up the steps. The mulch caught fire, which lit the siding on fire. No one's fire alarms went off. Someone driving by saw the smoke, stopped, ran and pulled the fire alarm, but it was only connected to the buzzer in the breezeway, not the fire alarms in the apartments. All bedrooms are in the back of the apartments, so no one heard it or woke up. He ran past the flames and banged on everyone's doors to wake people up. Fire department came and put out the fire pretty quick. It never got very big. I also caught the whole thing on my truck's dash cam, but can't find the video now. It was just one more thing that got us to leave apartments for good. Too many stupid people. I worked in an amusement park that allowed, at the time, smoking in most outdoor areas of the park. We had a couple mulch fires and trash can fires per day in a time it didn't rain. When my father-in-law was a kid, he really wanted to have a campfire. His parents told him no. He was determined to have a campfire, so he went up to his room and started one under his bed so they wouldn't know. I keep that knowledge in my back pocket for whenever he wants to imply I'm an idiot. My father was a Boston firefighter for 30 plus years. One of his more memorable stories was a foreign family who had ripped up their cast iron bathtub and built an open flame underneath the tub. They used the tub as a giant oil fryer. Naturally, this didn't work out very well, and the house caught fire. To add to the insanity even more, the family absolutely refused to let my dad and his coworkers in without taking their boots off. Which, of course, they couldn't agree to. Just crazy. Not a firefighter, and it wasn't in a house, but on a certain mall here in Monterrey, Mexico. We have a freaky plaza, a little mall where all the geeks, gamers and otakus go to, and on the second floor someone was smoking while playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Since he didn't want it to throw his ashes on the floor and the trash can was too far away from him, he decided to make a paper ashtray. Yeah, that didn't work out well, especially when three of his friends decided to use it to. Was in my local paper, turned out to be my friend's older brother. He tried to smoke out bees in the loft and set fire to the insulation in the loft, and burnt the whole house down. I was a chef, before I was on a volunteer fire department for a bit, and this was at a restaurant down the street from my old one. Cooks at this restaurant forgot to plug the drain in the deep fryer. So what happened was they put oil in a fryer, which drained immediately, right before lunch, turned on the empty fryer, and that's when the coils caught fire. So not only did they spill 5 gallons of oil, burn a fryer, fill a restaurant with smoke, and kill the service day, this was the second time it happened. Edit, grammar fixes, clarity. Not a firefighter, but happened in my building. In India generally you have small praying place in your house, like a little version of a temple. You lit the ayah, lamp, every day and pray there. In this particular case, the family decided to keep this thing on a fukin refrigerator. The DIY fell behind the fridge due to wind from the window adjacent to it. The condenser caught fire and literally exploded. The whole floor was on fire. Luckily no one was home. It really was a dumb decision to keep a temple on a fukin fridge. Oh yeah. I once saw a herd of a family who put their DIY near their power generator. Somehow the DIY fell into the generator and the house exploded. Luckily, they were not at home. My uncle is a firefighter. The answer is Christmas trees. They dry out, they become a ticking time bomb. He used to do an annual demonstration where he'd let a Christmas tree dry out for a few months, then take it outside and ignite it. The flames would shoot 40 feet in the air and the tree would be gone in a few seconds. It was mightily impressive to behold, and I'm sticking with artificial trees. For years we would collect everyone's discarded Christmas trees and build a bonfire with them on the beach slash shore of Lake Ontario for New Year's Eve. We'd stand on the 10 to 15 foot cliff above it, and the flames would be well above our heads, and so hot that we'd be shucking jackets and such. When the fire dropped, we'd sacrifice more trees down to the fire. It'd be fun to go down the next morning and see how far out the ice had melted from the shoreline. Not a firefighter, but I set my parents' bathroom on fire while getting up from the toilet. My mom used to leave potpourri simmering in a small bowl on the back of the toilet with a candle to heat slash stew it just below. As I was getting up, I somehow knocked the apparatus off the back of the commode. We had carpet floors in that bathroom and that section of the floor caught pretty quickly. The fire then found a seam in the wallpaper and ignited the glue fairly easily as well. As the flames rose, it caught the roll of toilet paper on the way up the wall, which really accelerated things. All this took 30 seconds, and I remember being somewhat mesmerized at the path the flames traveled. I also remembered that I had flushed the toilet before realizing what had happened. I somehow thought to grab the toilet bowl brush, shove it into the commode to get it wet, and then beat out the flames. The aftermath was surprisingly minimal. The small section of carpet was destroyed, but my parents replaced the carpet everywhere a few years later, the wallpaper wiped clean with some hot water and a rag, and thankfully there was only a little permanent smoke damage on the ceiling which has seemed to fade over time. The real sin here is your parents replacing your bathroom carpeting with new carpeting. Family friend decided to make major renovations on their home with no background in construction / carpentry. They also didn't bring a professional to ensure that their renovations were up to fire code. Lo and behold, an exposed wire sparked a fire in the middle of the night and burned down their entire home. They have 3 kids and are very fortunate they all were able to escape the fire without any injuries. To make matters even worse, they had no house insurance, extreme libertarians that don't believe in insurance / debt, so they ended up having to rely on a GoFundMe fundraiser, set up by a relative, to recover financially. Last I heard, they were still living in a hotel trying to figure out their next plan of action. This story alone reaffirms my belief that some things are better left to the professionals. Even if you're trying to cut costs, it might be best to pay a little extra to have someone with experience do something for you instead. This avoids terrible situations like this. Libertarians relying on a GoFundMe. That's amazing. Firefighter here. One extremely cold night, the temperature was minus 11, wind chills minus 40s. This guy tried starting a fire in his fireplace and couldn't get it started. He decides to use gasoline, dumps 1/2 gallon on the firewood, stacked by the door, and the other 1/2 onto the wood in the fireplace. As he attempted to light the fire, he couldn't get the lighter to work. Now the vapors are really starting to build. He then goes to the kitchen, which adjoins the room with the fireplace, to use the stove to light some newspaper. As soon as he turned the knob on the stove, the igniter let the gasoline vapors. The living room was instantly on fire. The vapor singed all his hair and got first degree burns on his hands and face. We on the other hand spent the next few hours in the extreme cold. Flash ahead 3 hours, the firewood outside has somehow ignited and we have to go back. The second fire had some time to really grow, middle of the night, everyone in bed, no one around. Longest, coldest night of my life, all because some fool decided to use gasoline to start a fire indoors. So, here in Argentina we have El Cordero a la Cruz, aka cooking a whole lamb with open fire. Well, it just so happens that pines are really flammable, and if you make an unprotected fire in a floor covered in pine leaves near a blooming pine. Not a firefighter, but the apt building I stayed in had a pretty good fire. Guy threw a lit cigarette in a coffee can full of butts. It was on the far end of the building from us, so my upstairs neighbor and I got to stay. Everyone else had to move. We were dealing with water leaks for almost a year after that. It took them that long to sort out insurance stuff and make repairs. Finally put on a new roof a few weeks before we moved. I hate people that do this. I work in a grocery store, and every couple of weeks in the summer, I have to play amateur firefighter because some idiot thought that throwing a lit cigarette into our outdoor ashtray was a good idea. Not a firefighter, but I read a story about a woman that started a fire because her firefighter friends were bored. I hope she didn't live in an apartment. I think it was in a house in the woods and the fire spread to the forest. Wow, that is a truly epic fail. It may have solved the boredom. Someone tried to make a gummy bear lamp like in iCarly to test it really gonna burn, and then his house was on fire. News article I read. One guy had a fishbowl in his garden shed. Sunlight was focused through the bowl, through his kitchen window. Fwoomf. I've never before thought to try to spell out that sound, and I think you did a really good job. They had 2 candles, and yeah, one thing led to another, and they burned down their home gym. 1. Once my neighbor stole 15 propane tanks and decided to make a DIY blowtorch. By neighbor I mean he lived below us. We were giving him our basement. He almost lit the house on fire, but then he tripped on something and fell over. The next morning we looked and saw it had burned a little bit, but not much. He was also very drunk that day, too. Once we lived in a basement suite and the people who lived above us were making toast at 2 a.m. and they used a fork to get it out. But the fork hit something, so the toaster caught fire and my mom tried to wake me up, but I just pulled my blanket over my head and said I just want to sleep a little more. And then my mom said the house could burn down, and I was the first one out of my house. My neighbors forgot they had ferrets inside. We grabbed our dog, but they didn't grab their ferrets. The fire department came, but my neighbors could have put out the fire if they unplugged the toaster and putting baking soda on it. My neighbors recently burned their house down emptying an ashtray before they went to bed. They have since quit smoking. My partner's a firefighter. He said the dumbest one was where a man tried to barbecue in his basement. His reasoning: I don't want to go outside and risk exposure to coronavirus. It would be safer to do it here in the basement. Mid-80s, near beginning of my career. Young lady finished putting flea spray on her pupa when she noticed a tick embedded in its flank. Ever hear of the tick removal technique in which you blow out a match and touch the hot tip to the tick, thereby causing it to back out of the dog? Yeah. Dog caught on fire. Little fellow ran under the bed, which also caught fire. Lady grabbed the pup with spray wet hands, and they too caught on fire. Long story short, the house was a mess, but both the lady and the dog fortunately survived with moderate burns. There was also the lady who tried to sanitize her panties in the microwave, but I was off that day. An old lady reading by candlelight set fire to Hampton Court Palace. I have been a firefighter for 20 years. The dumbest way I've seen a house fire start was when people squatting in a basement decided that a space heater would be handy in drying their clothes. Then they waited 15 minutes before calling for us, trying to put out with a garden hose into the basement on a 5-degree night. They burned down their home and the one next door. Not sure if this counts, but I nearly lit my house on fire trying to smoke toilet paper. My father lived in a rented apartment. The landlord lived in the apartment beneath him. My father had switched the fuse off the oven off because he had done some electrical work. He also put some receipts on the oven. In the meantime, the landlord saw the flipped off fuse located on the basement and flipped it on. We wondered why it smelled burned, and we discovered that the oven was on and had burned the paper to ash. Amazing, it did not really burn. The paper just didn't rot to ash. You could even still read some words, but if you touched it, it just turned to dust. I'm guessing the oven was set to something lower than 451 Fahrenheit. A guy had a bunch of ants coming through his wall. He started burning them with a butane torch, and it ended really badly. He thought it'd be okay, because the exterior wall was concrete. Yes, some people are that stupid. I'm not entirely sure if an actual fire was involved, but back when my dad was a firefighter, he and his colleagues were dealing with a 3-car pile up down one side of the motorway. People in the lane going the other way were rubbernecking so much that it caused another 3-car pile up on the other side of the motorway. He also told me of a time they were in their truck at a red light and noticed at the petrol station next to them there was a guy filling up his tank with a cigarette hanging out his mouth. When the light went to green, they drove out of that area as quick as they could. There was a show in the UK called 999 Lifesavers. There was one episode where some kids were dicking around with an old oil barrel. One tipped oil over himself, so he went to dry himself by their campfire they'd started, and wait, what? Not a firefighter, but I was living in a big old single family home that had been converted into 6 apartments. Because it was a house, it had a shingle roof. The owner hired one of those unlicensed, uninsured type outfits to work on the roof, the kind you find hanging out at Home Depot in the morning looking for jobs. Anyways, long story short, the guy was on the roof, smoking, and somehow caught it on fire. Rather than dialing 911, he ran down 3 flights of fire escape, got the garden hose, and ran it back up. Once he got to the top, he realized he never turned it on, so he ran back down, turned it on, and ran back up. Apparently by that time it was out of control, so he headed off. One of the neighbors finally called 911, but by then it was a full-on blaze, destroyed the top 2 floors and most of the first floor. Moral of the story is, just call the professionals. There was a spider. I'd say this is justified. Probably too late for this to get traction, but by far the dumbest is people smoking while on medical oxygen. Like, the tanks are coated in labels about how flammable it is. Edit, flammable is the incorrect term to use, as the oxygen itself will not burn. Mr. Homie Arwana was attempting to deep fry tater tots in a saucepan of oil on a gas stove. The oil frothed up when the frozen tots hit the surface, igniting the whole thing. Mr. Homie Arwana then proceeded to try to grab the pan by the handle and swing it over to the sink. I imagine it was like a Vietnam-era napalm run. Well, he managed to spread the fire across the linoleum floor and, in panic, let go of the pan, launching it, the remaining burning oil, and tots into the laundry basket, which was full of freshly dried clothes. In the ensuing panic, Mr. Homie Arwana thought he could try to get the flaming laundry basket out to the back porch. Well, he only managed to knock the flaming basket off the table, and it tumbled off the table and straight down the basement stairs, leaving an ice trail of burning oil-soaked towels all the way down. Now Mr. Homie Arwana decides to make egress out the back kitchen door, down the stairs to the backyard. He slightly missed the stairs, hit his bare right foot on one of the railing posts, breaking a couple toes, and flew forward off the staircase, managing to impale himself onto a bit of rubber that was protruding from a cement block they were using as a sort of barrier on the edge of the cement patio. There he stayed, clad only in boxer shorts. He managed to nick his liver pretty bad, but survived. Did I mention he had burned his legs up pretty bad as well? So, the smells and smoke and the screams of Mr. Homie Arwana at finding himself stuck through with a rusty piece of iron alerted Big Mama, Mr. Homie Arwana's girlfriend, and punk teen kids number 1 and 2 upstairs that something was afoot. As far as we could tell, Mama went looking for the kids or the dogs. Both dogs made it out. Girlfriend made it out and down the stairs over the raging laundry slash oil fire one flight below. She found Mr. Homie Arwana on the back patio, bleeding and turning gray, screaming and trying to get off the pike. The punk teen kids, with the dogs, climbed out a side bedroom window to the side porch roof. The older punk teen kid, about 16 years of age, managed to tumble off. He didn't land well. I think he ended up breaking his arm really bad. The dogs and the younger one got pulled off that roof by the neighbors. Mama apparently had a significant cardiac event and fell over. She happened to do so in the junk room, a sort of Clear Brothers style room filled shoulder high with stacked boxes of junk. By the time we got in there, it was just a charred, soaked mess of black slop about waist deep. We had to dig Mama out of it. That was wretched. All of this had attracted the attention of the many foreign laborers who were living in the boarding house next door. They helped the best they could, but also became a very raucous audience. A few of them were bomberos voluntarios back in Guatemala, and having an entire company of mostly non-English speaking vales show up intent on going to work made things very interesting. Two of those guys saved Mr. Homie Arwana's life though. I have never, in my 27 years of doing this, arrived on a scene of such screaming and chaos. Thanks for watching. Do you have something to share? Leave it in the comments. Please like and subscribe for more Reddit readings. Links mentioned in this video can be found in the description. Have a great day.